Welcome to Story Sparks, where we share stories that spark our imaginations, examine different points of view, and explore our big, wonderful world. I'm your host, Heather McGee. Today, I would like to share a story with you that has been very special in our family for many years. This is the story called Rechenka's Eggs. It was written and illustrated by Patricia Polacco. Now, in this story, you will see some beautifully colored eggs. These are designed and painted in Ukrainian style, and Ms. Polacco celebrates her family's heritage from the Ukraine and the Georgian region of Russia. You'll also hear about the city of Moskva, which is Moscow, which is a very big city in Russia. The main character is Babushka, a grandmother. Babushka lived alone in a dasha, a little house in the country, but she was known far and wide for the fine eggs that she lovingly painted. Her eggs were so beautiful that she always won first prize at the Easter festival in Moskva. There is Babushka. Each day, Babushka would take the shell of an egg from her basket and paint it in wonderful designs, using the shapes of stars and flowers, triangles and circles. Through the long, cold winter, Babushka painted. Look at the beautiful designs on her eggs. The work is very tiny, and she's using her glasses so that she could see. Then, one day, after a snowstorm, Babushka went outside. She could still hear the faint sound of falling snow. It was a sound like soft rain. Herds of caribou came to feed at Babushka's because the grasses they usually ate were covered with snow. "A miracle," she whispered as she fed some. "These wild things have found their way to me." Just then, a flock of noisy geese honked loudly overhead. As they glided over the snow, one of them faltered and fell from the sky. Babushka went to where the goose lay crumpled in the snow. "A hunter did this," Babushka grumbled. She carefully picked up the goose and took it back to her little house. See the goose falling? It's got an injury on its wing. There, she fed the little goose from her own table and put the goose in her best basket, lined with the warmest quilt from her own bed. "I shall name you a good name, one that we both can like, eh, my little friend?" she said as she patted the goose's head. "How do you like Rechenka?" "Yes, then Rechenka it shall be." With Babushka's care, Rechenka grew stronger as each day passed. To repay her kindness, Rechenka laid an egg for breakfast every morning. See, Rechenka is sleeping in the basket with a quilt. Oh dear. As Rechenka got better, she waddled around the little house, exploring every nook, cupboard, and corner. One day, she jumped up on Babushka's work table, overturning the jars of bright-colored paint that she used to color the eggs. "Nyet!" Babushka screamed as she chased the goose with a broom. "No!" The frightened goose flapped her wings to get away and knocked over the basket of eggs that Babushka had so lovingly painted. The eggs crashed onto the floor and shattered into millions of pieces. They were both very sad. There was no reason now for Babushka to go to the festival. Oh my goodness. The next morning, Babushka slowly got out of bed and trundled over to Rechenka's basket to get her morning egg. But when she reached into the middle of the quilt, she picked out the most brilliantly colored egg she had ever seen. "A miracle," whispered Babushka. "A miracle. Look at that egg. It's all colored. That is very special, because geese don't normally lay colored eggs like that." She made small holes at both ends of the egg and blew the yolk and white into a dish to cook and eat later for her breakfast. Then she held the egg up to the morning light and marveled at its beauty. After that, every morning for 12 mornings, there was another egg, each more beautiful than the one laid the day before. Soon Babushka had enough eggs to take to the festival in Moskva. "How wonderful," she thought. "A miracle has replaced the eggs that were broken. That's very special." "Spring is here, my little friend," Babushka said to Rechenka the morning of the festival. "Soon now you will be flying off to the north with your flock." She bustled to the hearth fire and brewed some of her most favored tea. The two shared a saucer of tea with kulich, a sweet Easter bread. She covered each piece with pashka, a spread of cheese, butter, and raisins. They savored each bit together. "One for you, one for me," Babushka chanted. "Da, da. My little friend, I shall sorely miss you, but you are a wild thing, and a miracle sent you to me. It would not be right to ask you to stay here with me forever." When Babushka left her little house, she took one last look at Rechenka, sitting on the doorstep. She waved, then took determined steps for Moskva with the basket of her precious eggs. She crossed Lebetov Valley, where the caribou mothers were walking their newborn calves. You see the little baby caribou here? There's another one. A miracle, she thought. New little lives. A miracle. She crossed the bridge over the Moskva River, and soon she could see the onion domes of old Moskva. Those are really cool roofs, aren't they? Look how beautiful. The festival was bright and exciting. There were goat carts selling kulich, processions, dancers, jugglers, and laughing children playing and running. Babushka showed her old friends the eggs. "Her eggs are the most beautiful in all Russia," they thought. "Look at them," the elders said. "They almost glow, as if the paint is part of the shell itself." The judges picked Babushka's eggs as the most beautiful. Babushka was so happy. She beamed as she looked at the first prize, a feather bed quilt. As Babushka made her way homeward, a honking flock of geese flew overhead. Babushka gave them a long, lingering look. She wondered if Rechenka was one of them. When Babushka arrived home that evening, Rechenka was gone. Alone, she put the new quilt on her little bed. She brewed a cup of tea, ate the last of the kulich and pashka, got into bed with her favorite book of poems, and drifted off to sleep. She hadn't noticed Rechenka's basket. Do you remember Babushka had given Rechenka the quilt, and now Babushka's got her own quilt? Do you see anything different in the basket? Babushka hadn't seen it yet. But that night, Babushka was awakened from a sound sleep by an ever so small sound. It was coming from Rechenka's basket. She hobbled closer and saw a glorious egg. But this one was different from all of the others. It quivered and moved. It made tiny muffled sounds. The egg jumped, bumped, rolled and pitched in the basket. What do you think is happening? Then there was a crack, and Babushka could see the very special gift that Rechenka had left for her. All a miracle, Babushka said. And this little goose remained with Babushka always. And that's the end of today's story. Babushka was a very special person, wasn't she? Do you have grandparents that you especially like? Grandparents can be very wise, and they share wonderful stories with us. Babushka did not have any children around her, but she knew when she saw miracles. She knew when the caribou came to visit her, that that was a special gift from God. When Rechenka, the goose, was shot, Babushka took very good care of it. And Rechenka repaid her with eggs. That was a big thing because Rechenka accidentally knocked all of those beautiful decorated eggs out of the basket and onto the floor. I'm sure Rechenka did not mean to do that. Rechenka was just exploring. Babushka was very sad, but Rechenka repaid her by laying beautiful colored eggs for the next 12 days. What a lovely gift. Very special. And that was to say thank you for Babushka's kindness. Babushka was finally able to go to the festival in Moskva, and she won the first prize with those beautiful eggs. When she finally got home, she was very tired. It had been a long day. And she snuggled into bed. But what happened in the middle of the night? You're right. Babushka woke up because she heard a sound. It was a little tapping, tapping. And then she noticed the one last beautiful gift that Rechenka had left for her. What was that little gift? Yes, a baby goose. That's a gosling. And even though Rechenka had gone back to fly with the rest of her goose friends and family, the baby that was left with Babushka stayed with her forever. That's really neat, isn't it? We all have troubles that we run into. Accidents happen. Things happen that make us really upset. But we can work to be like Babushka, to recognize the beauty and the miracle in everyday things, and know that God is always looking out for us. Things don't always go the way we wish they would, but our lives are filled with miracles if only we take the time to notice. Thank you for joining me today. Happy Easter. Goodbye.